How do you want to document your life? You want to document your business, like all the way around, like round and round and round and round and round, like Document 360, who's kindly sponsoring this video. If you have an online business, it's important for digital documentation. If I had all the different ways that I consulted clients, made videos, and all the other things I did in my business just in my head and not technically documented, my life would suck. Document 360 takes the suck out of technical documentation by allowing you to do multiple things that are not really capable in other applications by creating a knowledge base that really works for your business. Going into the application itself, you'll see that one, the aesthetic's pretty nice. And two, you're able to go into your dashboard like what I have here at Rise Productive and really build out a system that makes sense for your business. So going to the homepage builder here, I really like the way that this allows you to set up a view for your team that works really well. So for example, if we look at any of these different categories, like the category manager or editor, you can see that we can actually set up a new category on the left here. And what this allows you to do is make either a folder, index, or page of different categories. So if we go here and put content, then I added this here. We could also update it to go from a folder to an index very quickly, or a page as well. So I'm gonna go back and make it a folder. And if we add an article here, I'm gonna take an article that shows how to create podcasts and upload. In this editor, you're able to do a lot of nice things like insert tables, images, files, and even do find and replaces like you would with anything else that is a nice text editor. Same goes for inserting videos. I'm just going to paste in really quickly here a nice setup that I had from a Notion process doc, and it was from Markdown, and you'll see it took all this editor Markdown stuff and made it look like this on the front end. So if I press view preview here, well, it looked funky in the editor. What it will do is allow you to take Markdown and quickly and easily pop this in here. Now, if I want to go back to here, what I can do is I can take this section and insert a video, copy this link really quickly, and then do the exact same thing here with this. What you have now is some videos that are just embedded in here. And if we go to the preview again, you'll see from the perspective of somebody who'd be in your portal, would they be able to quickly go through all the different steps that it would take in order to create a podcast for Rise Productive? And you'd be able to easily go in here and you'd be able to easily watch the embedded videos as well. Now, another section outside of the editor that's really cool is the drive. So this essentially takes all the important documents that you need on your backend and sort of documents it and allows you to change who has access to it as well. And you can also go here and set the editor folder. And in a company where you have a lot of sensitive information, this can be very useful, or even just is nice to have basic file storage in general within the drive. Like for example, if you go to view site here and then go to drive, you'll see that it has that documentation within here, and the drive takes in the different categories that you had over in the documentation and puts them into folders so that people can see them like that if you had it set as a folder. Within here, you can also change it from light to dark mode, and it's got even nice table of content breakouts just like that. As you can see, I had priorly made a little upload to our favicon here. If we go back to the homepage, we can see that there's some other options too, like analytics, which are cool to look at. You can see that as well in the back end, but the point of the analytics is to essentially figure out if it was a public page or if it was a private page. Where are people coming from? And are they liking your articles? Are they disliking your articles? What are they viewing? And it also does a good job of showing when pages are not found and different tickets, link statuses, so that you can see what's broken and what's working, what's internal and external, and even the different searches that'll be on here. If you had a content tools, you're also able to do things like make new templates. So say for example, you can set a Markdown template that would allow you to consistently make articles in the company. You can even make review reminders available. So for example, if I go here, make new blog post, you could add that. It would tell me to make a new blog post every 2 weeks. What's really nice here too, is that it actually has SEO stuff built in. So whether that be meta title, meta description, you're able to add those different things to the articles so that you add an SEO component to those public articles. So when you're in this documentation section here, in order to publish it, what you're gonna do is press publish here, and then you press this link here, you're gonna see it in the knowledge base itself. And then if we press open in portal, it'll open the article back up right here for you to edit it as well. In the top right, what you can do is you can actually add different contributors here, and you can always set it back to in review or draft and change where it's at in the process. From a security perspective, you can change it to knowledge base portal has access control. You can change the different people who have access to it here. Add team account groups. And the same goes with the knowledge base site, where you can make it public or private, so only those with an account can access it, or you can make it public so everyone can access your site and have no login required. If we go to settings and go to users and security, you'll see that you're able to go and set it so that everyone can access your site. And then you can put in the subdomain. So riseproductive.360.io, or you can set it to private so that only those in that account can access your site. So then if I did this really quick, and then went to the website on another browser, you'll see that it forces me to try to do a login here. But then it also can do mix so that you can add the flexibility to have some things be public and some things be private. And you can change this access type in the security settings in all the different categories as well. This is the unique value add of Document 360. It is a privately hosted security option facility for your documents. And that's reflected in the pricing. You have various plans, whether it be for free, startup, business, or enterprise. And even just for the free plan, I mean, you do get a lot of different articles for a small company if you want to have those different things here. You're not going to get a crazy amount less for this free version, and it will at least get you a taste of the different ways that you can utilize that private hosting to its full advantages. Obviously, this video is catered towards businesses more than individuals, so take that into account. And take into account this video on how to improve your productivity even more.